For lecture two quiz review, it's all on the fundamentals of the scientific method. Now, about half of your questions will look like this, where the answers will be observation, hypothesis, experiment, conclusion. I will also throw in theory there, but generally that's not going to be a right answer when you're dealing with these questions. And so in most scenarios of the questions you'll have on the quiz, these will be your answers, and I will describe something that we've talked about in the lecture or something from your book that is used as an example of the scientific method, like the car example I give you in the lecture, and say, oh, when you do this, this is what part of the scientific method, right? Generally, everyone does well on these except for the conclusion questions, because what they fail to realize, at least for this class, is the emphasis on the conclusion is the rejection or support of the hypothesis. And that's what you're seeing with these two arrows right here, is if the hypothesis is supported, that's one outcome for your conclusion. If the hypothesis is not supported, then you go back and you revise your hypothesis and then you do the experiment again, right? So support or reject of the hypothesis. A lot of times people mess it up because when I say, oh, you're analyzing your data, they think that's the conclusion. Or when you're crunching your numbers and creating the graphs, they think that's the conclusion. No, when in doubt, it's usually the experiment, the analysis of the data. All of that has to be done before you make your conclusion. So just keep that in mind. That's one of those helpful hints as you're doing this. The others are pretty straightforward as it comes to observation, hypothesis, experiment, but that's usually where people get messed up. So that's why I like to make an emphasis on that for this. Remember, theory doesn't come till much later. And in general, you're not going to have any questions on theory except for here. So these, you'll have a couple of questions on your quiz. Make sure you know the difference between a hypothesis, theory, principle, and law. At this stage of the game, it's generally definitions of these terms, but there are also some questions that may give you an example of what you're seeing up here, okay? We haven't done too many theories yet, right? And we haven't discussed too many principles or laws. We will this semester, and this is why you need to know this information. So there are a couple questions which will ask things like, which of the following correctly describes the difference between a hypothesis and a theory, or between a theory and a principle? Or it may define one of these, like the law, and say, you know, what part of the scientific, what progression of the scientific method is that? Again, these are all just increases in knowledge. Hypothesis, that's a guess. Theory is when we've validated that hypothesis for a lot of experiments. Principle, remember, those are the particular facts that explain how things work, but they're not the theory themselves. They basically explain how things work within the theory. The law is everything. It not only explains how, but why. And with that, we can predict how things will occur under certain circumstances, right? So make sure you know the difference between these four. Those are definitely questions that will show up on your quiz. Now, the last questions you're going to have on your quiz are on independent, dependent, and standardized variables. Basically, what are the changeable elements of an experiment? And the reason why I like to focus on that is because as we move forward and as we learn about science, you'll learn that it is not an easy thing to be able to determine and gain knowledge through these experiments, because all these things must be done correctly to be able to get reliable data. And so I want you to be able to be familiar with these. Now, you're not going to use these again in future lectures, but I want you to be familiar with them, which is why I've got several questions on these. Included in these, so these will generally be the answers, but included in these are concepts like the placebo and the double blind, because it plays into these three. For example, placebo, that's part of the independent variables. Why? Because it's what you're manipulating. It's what you are controlling and changing. It's a zero value, but it still is a manipulated value. Okay, so the placebo is not a dependent. Dependent is the outcome, right? standardized variables, this has to do with the double blind, because what happens is you do X, you should get Y. You do your independent variables, you should get the reliable outcome, the dependent variables. Standardized is keeping everything else consistent. That's why the double blind is done, to not introduce additional variables that mess up your independent variables, that mess up what you control. You're not introducing new things. And so the double blind is considered part of the standardized variables because you're trying to keep everything consistent. If you give placebo and drug, they look the same. You give them in the same way. The people themselves don't know, so that they don't introduce bias into it. Okay, so that's going to come up as well as just defining and understanding. Now I'm going to use examples that we talked about in class, like the virus, vaccination for children, or the treatment of plants, or the bacteria with ulcers effect. I'm going to give those as examples, and you will then say, oh, that's the independent variable, that's the dependent, or that's the standardized variables. Okay. So those are the last few questions you're going to have on lecture 2 quiz.